the Quiztainment, our first edition, is cricket. The preliminary rounds for this round were held on 8th May and top four contestants are participating in the final round. To encourage our amazing content, please like, share and subscribe our channel. Also, the link for UPI contributions is there in the description box. Our viewers can contribute to keep this content going. Before beginning, I would request our participants to kindly introduce themselves in crisp two lines. Akhil will go first. You are not audible, Akhil, I guess.
No, Akhil, you are not audible.
Akhil,
just rejoin
not
again.
Audible, yes. Okay, Piyush, you can go next.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Yeah, so myself, Piyush Kumar Jha, and I'm from West Bengal, and I'm currently pursuing my graduation in political science from Delhi University. Thank you.
Welcome, Piyush. Shubham, you can introduce yourself.
Yes. Hi, everyone. This is Shubham Khandelwal. I'm from Jaipur, Rajasthan. I have done BE in Mechanical Engineering and Masters in Economics from BITS Pilani. And currently, I'm pursuing Indian Economic Services.
Welcome, Shubham. Saujanya, you can introduce yourself.
Hello, my name is Saujanya Mukherjee. I am from Kolkata. I'm currently pursuing Bachelor's in English Literature, and I'm also a UPSC aspirant.
Welcome, Saujanya. Mani, has Akhil joined? Like,
yeah, he's just connecting to his audio.
Okay, we will wait for him. Once he joins, please let me know.
So all the viewers have joined us live. I request you to, if you like our content and our initiative at Bharata First, you can contribute to us via the live chat option, that's present, and also through the UPI IDs that's there in the description of the video. Akhil, are you ready? You can unmute yourself. No, you are not audible. You can join from some other device maybe.
Yes.
And try again.
Try earphones, I guess.
By that time, we want to know how you liked our preliminary round of the Quiztainment.
You can give a review about the questions in preliminary round in Quiztainment. Piyush, you can go first.
So the preliminary round was actually quite interesting. The questions were phrased in a tricky manner. Some questions were a bit tricky. And I personally liked all the questions. And seeing the scores of the qualifying participants, it seems that it was quite a high scoring round.
Yes. Shubham, your experience, like, you can share about preliminary rounds.
Yes, sir. I agree with Piyush. The questions were really interesting. And I mean, they were not straightforward questions. So you need to have a holistic understanding of IPL and cricket. Like, if you have followed IPL over the years, then only you will be able to, you know, answer the questions.
Thank you, Shubham. Saujanya, your views?
Yes, the questions were quite interesting. And I personally found those X and Y ones a little confusing sometimes. And we had to do some serious brainstorming for a few of the questions because they have happened past.
Yes. And also to our viewers, our big picture quizzes are held every day from Monday to Friday. And the top five participants there participate in Saturday's mega quiz, big picture. And it will be also be going live tomorrow. So please do support us and keep viewing our content on our Bharata First YouTube channel. And for the big picture quizzes, we also have a special Wednesday for Women Day, where the top top spot is reserved for a woman contestant, and hence we have six participants in our big picture mega quiz, five regular toppers and one from the Wednesday for Women winner. It will be airing tomorrow, so please do watch that quiz also. Akhil.
Hello, sir. Am I
Yes,
audible now?
you are audible now. So introduce yourself in two lines. We will start with the quiz.
My name is Akhil Salimat and I am studying mechanical engineering in Hubli. I am currently in sixth semester.
Welcome, Akhil. So without much delay, I will move to the rules of the today's quiz. The quiz will be conducted in infinite bounds method. So that is a type of method conducting a quiz. You need to keep your cameras turned on at all the times. Please answer only when your chance comes. Do not unmute unnecessarily. Use of any unfair means will lead to disqualification. And in case of any dispute, the decision of the quiz master would be final. And today I am your quiz master. My name is Chidanand. So without much delay, we will begin with the quiz. There will be a
I think there is some connection issue with you, Chidanand, or is it just me?
No,
is
it's
he
with
audible,
everyone.
Guys?
We are facing.
No, he's not audible.
Okay, just one second. We'll check if he's joining back. Roman, would you confirm?
I think I'm audible to everyone, right?
Yeah.
I'm audible, right?
Yes, you are.
Okay. There are total 20 questions in this quiz, plus 10 for each correct answer, and after hint, 5 marks. I will explain once what the infinite bounds method is. Like if a question is directed directly to a first participant, and if it does not answer, it passes to the next participant. And in this way, after first round, if none of them answers, I will give a hint. And after answering, if I give a hint and then the contestant answers, the mark is reduced to 5. And if in both the rounds, none of the participants answer, we will move to the next question. And after I finish reading the question, approximately 20 to 30 seconds will be provided to think and answer. I hope I am clear with the rules, right? We will begin with the quiz. And first question is to Akhil. The Big Appeal Cricket's Day of Giving was a set of three cricketing events on 8th and 9th February 2020 aimed at raising relief for those affected by the 2019-20 Australian X season. The three events included the X Cricket Bash, the Commonwealth Bank Women's Tri Series, T20 international match between India and Australia, and the final of the Big Bash League. Identify this term X. I want the term X and concentrate on the years, and I hope you'll get the answer. Akhil, this is directly to you. Unmute yourself while answering. Think of the
X is the name of the event, right?
Yeah, it was conducted for raising relief for some event, and this event occurred in 2019-20 in Australia. So there were a total of three events, and all of these were conducted for raising relief for that event. Give me that term X for me, like the event which occurred in Australia.
Australian bushfire.
Okay, that's the right answer. So plus 10 for Akhil. Next question goes to Piyush. Lords, Eden Gardens, MCG, Gaddafi Stadium, Wanderers, Kensington Oval, Wankhede. This is an exhaustive list. That means no other name can fit into this list. I want the relation between all of them. Read them and give me what I am trying to say. Like, what do they signify? This is directly to Piyush. Read the list and tell me what is the relation between all of them.
Hosts of the World Cup final, venues of the World Cup final.
Okay, that is the right answer. These are the venues of the ICC World Cup final. Well done, Piyush. We move to the next question, and it is directed to Shubham. What is being talked here around the cricketing globe? It was widely accepted. A lot of teams were doing it. You haven't seen any reverse swing since that incident as a general statement across world cricket. very minimal reverse swing. The positive that has come out with that punishment is it seems to have been eradicated from the game because it was getting out of control around the entire cricket world, not just the Australian cricket team. What is being talked here, Shubham? This is directly to you.
The ball tempering incident which happened in 2018.
Like, give me that specific name for that incident.
Sandpaper Gate.
Okay. That is the right answer. That is the Sandpaper Gate incident. So, all our participants are doing very well. So, we will move to the that next question is Saujanya's direct. X was an Indian cricketer and was also a political activist. X was born in Dharwad, the then Bombay Presidency, British India. X had three brothers who also played first-class cricket. X was also a close friend of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. In 1937, X contested the Bombay Legislative Assembly elections against Dr. B.R. Ambedkar but lost. Give me that X. Like, who is X? He was a cricketer and also a social activist. This question is directly to Saujanya. You can unmute yourself, Saujanya.
No, I'll take a pass.
You have time, like you can guess if you know. Think, okay. The question is passed to Akhil. Unmute your mic, Akhil, while answering. So like the hints are there in the question. It is a type of a historical question of Indian cricket. So you can think, like, who is that personality? X also contested the elections in 1937 against B.R. Ambedkarji, but lost it. He is from Dharwad. It is your district. So think. Any guesses, Akhil?
Actually, I know the second name, but the first name I'm not able to recall.
I want the full name, like, then only the points will be given. Any guesses?
Palwankar Bablu.
I will give a chance to refine your answer. Like, the first name is correct. Any chance to improve your answer?
No, that's all I can recall. I don't pass.
Okay. I will give you a 5 marks. Like, you gave the first part correct. Piyushja, you can try. Like, if you know the answer, you will get 5 points.
Is it Palwankar Balu?
Yes, it is Palwankar Balu. So the marks get split between Piyush and Akhil, 5 each. The next question will be to Shubham. So here is he, Palwankar Balu. The next question will be to Shubham. Only 3 Indians have batted on all 5 days of test cricket. M.L. Jaisimha and Pujara are 2 of them. Identify the 3rd player. This player achieved another feat that has been achieved only 7 times in all forms and levels of cricket combined. Herschel Gibbs is one of those 7 players. This is directly to Shubham. Like, give me the player who has batted, who is the 3rd Indian player to bat all 5 days of test cricket. And he has also achieved another feat. Like, that feat has been achieved only 7 times in all forms of cricket. All forms in the sense international, domestic, club cricket altogether. Give me that player name. The hint is there in the question. Like, you can read the question once. Clearly, the second para is the hint.
So, Virendra Sehwag?
No, Saujanya, you can take a try.
Will it be? Will I get negative if I am wrong?
No, negative. No negative marking. No negative.
Sunil Gavaskar?
No. Akhil?
Ravi Shastri.
Yes, Ravi Shastri is the right answer. like 7 times totally 6 sixes have been hit in an over, and also Ravi Shastri has had hit that. So that was a hint in the question. So our next question will be directly to Piyush Jha. I assured Rahul that the incident would have no bearing on my involvement on the field, but off the field, I would prefer to be left alone for a while to come to terms with what had happened. X writes in the book, despite this incident, I am glad to say Rahul and I remained good friends, and even on the field, our camaraderie remained intact until the end of our careers. We continue to have some good partnerships, and neither our cricket nor our friendship was affected. Identify X and which event is being talked here. This is directly to Piyush Jha. Like, this is said by X about a specific event. Give me who has said this or written this, and what event is X talking about here?
Is it Sachin Tendulkar and the declare and Rahul Dravid's decision to declare the innings when while Sachin was batting on 194?
Yes, that is the complete and correct answer. Well done, Piyush. It is Sachin Tendulkar's book. It is written in Sachin Tendulkar's book by him, and it is the Multan Declaration, the stadium where it was played. So our next question will be to Shubham. The Indian cricket team toured England in the 1911 season and played 23 matches, of which 14 were first class. It was the first tour by an all-Indian team. The Indians won just two of their first class fixtures, drew two and lost 10. The team was captained by X, who was an avid cricket lover. He also built the highest cricket ground in Chail in India, which was his summer retreat. Identify X. So see the timeline. It was the time when princely states were there in India. So I'm giving a hint before everyone answers. And he was the captain of that team which toured England in 1911. He has also built the highest cricket ground in India. Give me the name of X. Shubham, it is to you.
Sorry, sir, I will pass this question.
Okay, Saujanya, you can take a try.
No, sir, I'll take a pass.
Okay, Akhil?
I think it is Maharaja Bhupinder Singh.
Okay, we will see the answer. That is the right one, Maharaja Bhupinder Singh. And we will move to the next question, and it's Piyush's direct. Jonty Rhodes' wife, Melanie Jane, gave birth to a baby girl in a Santa Cruz hospital in Mumbai in 2015. I have spent a lot of time here. What I love about India is that it's a rich mix of culture, heritage, and tradition. It is a very spiritual country, very forward-thinking nation. I really like that combination. You have to have a good balance of life, said Jonty Rhodes. Like, what am I trying to connect here? This is to Piyush Jha.
Yeah, so Jonty Rhodes means, as he has described, that he has spent quite a lot of time here. So as a result, he named his daughter India.
Yes, that is the right answer. Jonty Rhodes has named his daughter as India when she was born here. Yes, well done, Piyush. So the next question is to Shubham. The Indian cricket team toured England in the 1932 season under the title of All India. They were captained by the Maharaja of Porbandar. It was the national team's second tour of England following the one in 1911. What was so special about this tour? This is to Shubham. This was the second time they traveled after 1911, but some specific event happened there in 1911. So in 1932, so what was that event? Like, it was very special. This is to Shubham.
Sir, India beat England for the first time in test match.
No, Saujanya, you can take a try.
India won the first match ever in cricket.
No, Akhil?
I don't have any clue about this.
Okay, Piyush?
Well, I will just take a random guess.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. This is all about guessing.
Yeah. So, is it related to something political, means the match was...
No, no, no. Okay. So, I will give a hint now. So, the question reduces to 5 marks. Like, this is a very historical moment for every player. So, that is the hint. If I give more hints, then the answer will be directly known to all of you. Like, this is a dream of every player, every cricket player. So, the question was to Shubham. You can take a try now.
India's first test match?
Yes, it is India's first test match. And there is a second part to it. So, now you have got like 2.5 marks. If you give the second half, then you will get the answer. Like, half is correct.
All of the players made their debut in that match.
No. Saujanya, take a guess. Like, you can try a wild guess. This is all about guessing. Enough hints are there in the question. Like, I have also given a hint. Saujanya, this you can try. Any guesses? Okay, Akhil, you can try.
India won their first overseas test match.
No. Like, Shubham has given half the answer, but I need the other part of it. Like I said, it's... So, this is turn of Piyush.
So, I will guess that all the playing members of the team were Indian.
No. Like now nobody will get the points, but can any of them try guess? Like, he said it is India's first test match. That was true, but it was also played at Lord's. It was India's inaugural match at Lord's in 1932. So that was the answer. Like, I hope you play cricket, like all of you, like all the four. Well, you play cricket.
Yes.
So like, I'd like to ask Piyush, what was his favorite moment of watching cricket? Like, what moment or the first moment you remember of playing cricket, Piyush?
Yeah, so as I have started watching cricket in this century, in the 21st century, so it's quite obvious that the most remarkable moment in the history of Indian cricket in the 21st century is that World Cup victory and that six by Mahendra Singh Dhoni.
Okay, you are a millennial guy. So, Shubham, any of your favorite moments, like you remember the first time?
Sir, I can remember the, of course, 2011 is the, you know, most, the moment which we cherish the most. But before that, in 2007, when the India won the T20 World Cup. So, it was any kind of World Cup which India won after 1983. So, that was very special.
Okay, nice. Like, my first moment was me holding a plastic bat and playing with a plastic ball with my father. Like, that was very special to me. And also watching all the highlights, whatever highlights they put on. I think the broadcasting rights was with Neo Cricket then. So, it 24 hours, that channel would be on in my home. So, that is my moment. So, let us proceed with the quiz. And next question will be to Saujanya. It will be Saujanya's direct. Connect these dates related to a specific event of a cricketer. Like, look at these dates. These dates say something about a cricketer, like his event, like something he did. So, connect them to a specific player. These dates are related to him. It is Saujanya's direct. You can unmute yourself. Any guesses, Saujanya? Any guesses?
No, sir, I have no clue.
Okay, Akhil?
No idea.
You can guess, like, these dates are related to a player's event, like, he can be known debut. By these. Okay, Piyush? You can take a guess.
Yeah, so these are the dates of Shahid Afridi's retirement, the times he has announced retirement and came.
Yes, that is the right one. Like these are the dates when Shahid Afridi announced his retirement, but later retracted them many times. So Piyush, how did you know this answer? Like you took a guess or you knew about these dates?
Yes, it is quite popular in this, means in a funny way that people usually mock Shahid Afridi.
Many times it took, I also read many times in the newspapers. I thought that was a tough question, but yes, well done, Piyush. So now we will reverse the order. Like 10 questions are over now. So the question, this question will be directly to Saujanya. So now we'll go in a reverse order. So it is Saujanya's direct. In 2012, West Indies and Bangladesh played out a test match at Mirpur. West Indies won the toss and opted to bat first on what was a dry wicket at Mirpur. Bangladesh had lined up with a slew of spinners, including debutant Sohag Ghazi, a debutant off-spinner. Chris Gayle and Kyron Powell came to open for Windies. Like, there is something special about this test match. Focus on the hints in the question, like West Indies had many spinners and Chris Gayle and Kyron Powell came to open for Windies. Something happened in this match, like it has not been repeated again or was not there till then. This is Saujanya's direct. Like there are many off spinners and I have mentioned the batsman's name. So think what can be done in this test match. Like take a wild guess. Do not be shy of guessing if it goes wrong, because these questions are all about guessing. So you can take a guess.
Bangladesh did not play any fast bowlers.
No, but that was a good guess. So Akhil, you can guess. It's Shubham's turn.
Sir, were all the wickets taken by fast bowlers?
No, you are all are guessing very nicely. But Piyush, this goes to you.
Yeah, so my guess is that the very first ball of the test match was dispatched for a six by the universe boss, Chris Gayle.
Yes, that is the right answer. Chris Gayle hit the first match of a test match for a six, and it has never been repeated again, nor was it there before. So anyway, nice guesses, participants. Like keep guessing like this, funny guesses, it will be nice. And also to our viewers, like it was the season of IPL, which all of us miss due to the pandemic. Like you can comment in the section, like which team you like and why you like that IPL team. So that will be nice to read, but please maintain some dignity. Do not start a war there. So as Piyush answered this, the next question will go to Akhil. The match was abandoned as a draw as the news that X was assassinated reached. The rest of the tour was called off. Identify X. Like, look at the question and the picture carefully. You will definitely get to know this. Akhil, this is your direct. Read the question carefully and also look at the picture carefully.
It was assassination of Indira Gandhi.
Yes, but how did you come to know? Like,
because that was the only time when this event has happened, because she was the prime minister then.
Okay. And also any other participants, if you know, like how would you try to guess this answer if you don't know anything about related to politics?
So the date, I guessed it by date, October 31st, 1984.
Yes, October 31st, 1984 is there in the question. So you can, that was the day when Mrs. Indira Gandhi was assassinated. Okay, the next question will be to Saujanya. Okay, we are going reverse. This is to you, Saujanya. Cricket has been a sport at the modern Summer Olympic Games. The only time it has been played was at the X, with only a men's contest between two teams, Great Britain and France. Identify X, like when was it? Like which Olympic Games or when was it? It was played only once, cricket in Olympics, and it was between Great Britain and France. Saujanya, it's your turn. Olympics happen every 4 years, so you can answer directly any Olympics if you don't know. Any guesses?
No.
Okay, Shubham, you can take a guess. Like, you can answer the question.
No idea, sir.
Okay, Piyush?
Is it the 1904 Olympics?
Which? 1900?
1904.
No, Akhil?
No idea.
Okay.
2004.
No. I will give a hint now. Like, at that time, Lord Curzon was the Viceroy of India. So you can take a guess. Guess what is Lord Curzon's viceroyship time, and you can take a guess. Saujanya, you can try.
Is it 1833-ish?
No. Shubham?
Sir, 1892?
No. Piyush? Unmute yourself.
Yeah. So I was confused between 1904 and 1908. So 1908 is my choice.
1908?
Yeah.
No. Akhil?
No idea about that.
Okay. The answer is 1900. So Piyush, you could have come minus 4. Instead of doing plus 4, you could have done minus 4. In 1908, I guess Curzon was not the viceroy. It was, I think, Minto or Morley. Okay. So all of you watch IPL?
Yes.
Like in correct order, you can say, with starting with Akhil, you can say, which is your favorite IPL team? Like
RCB.
Okay. Why?
Because the time when I first started watching IPL, I knew nothing about IPL. My brothers started supporting RCB when I was like, let's support RCB.
Nice. Piyush?
Well, as I am from Kolkata, so the obvious choice is Knight Riders.
Yeah, Knight Riders. Russell Power. Shubham?
Sir, I like Rajasthan Royals, but of course, you know, they don't win too much, but yeah, but still that emotion is with Rajasthan.
Okay, Saujanya?
Same as Piyush, I'm from also Kolkata, so KKR.
Okay, KKR, what is the tagline of KKR? I forgot. Korbol Orbo Jitbo, no?
Yes, Korbol Orbo Jitbo.
Okay, but I first used to like Mumbai Indians. Because in 2008, when I was a small child, I didn't know what was IPL. So I thought the name India is there in that team. So let's support Mumbai Indians. And also Sachin was there in that. So but later, all my sisters and brothers used to support RCB as they were elder to me. But then later, I changed it in 2009. Because in 2008, I guess both Mumbai and RCB played very badly. Both were at the bottom of the table. So I got angry. So I changed it to RCB. So like... this question was directly to whom? Like Saujanya, no?
Yes.
As no one answered, this will go to Shubham now. The next question. A test match between England and West Indies at Old Trafford in 1933. Ellis Ekong, who bowled slow left-arm orthodox spin, had Walter Robbins stumped off a surprise delivery that spun into the right-hander from outside the off-stump. As he walked back to the pavilion, Robbins reportedly said to the umpire, "Fancy being done by a bloody X," leading to the more widespread use of the term X. Identify the term X. Like X is a term. It was first used by Walter Robbins in 1933 because the ball spun from the outside the off stump into the right hander. So give me that term X. Shubham, it is to you. Like there is a hint in the question, a very big hint. Of the delivery, like you can guess what that term or that person X who does it, does this. Yeah,
is it googly, sir?
No. Piyush,
is it the Chinaman?
Yes, that is the Chinaman. Well done, Chinaman. These people are very rare, no? Like left arm orthodox spinners. Like, how did you come to know the answer, Piyush? unmute. Right.
So I have read it somewhere. I don't recall where I have read it, but.
Right. Well done. So the next question will be directly to Akhil. The first team of X was RCB, but he did not play a single match and was dropped the next season. The X was picked by SRH in 2013 and played till 2016 for them, including the winning season of 2016. In 2017, X was picked by Mumbai Indians and played 9 games and also won the title. In 2018, he was picked by CSK and also played 6 games and won the IPL title, leading him to hold a unique record of winning 3 IPL titles consecutively with 3 different teams. Post-2018, he is with CSK but has not won a title. He has also played 1 test, 2 ODIs and 1 T20 for India, all in 2014. Identify the player X. Like, who is he?
He did not play in RCB, right?
He was picked by RCB, but he did not play. Read the question like you can guess. There are 3 parts in this question. 2008, 13, 16, 17 and 18. So try to guess. Like, everyone knows this player, but they don't know specifically this record. Like, even I was surprised to see this.
I think it's Karan Sharma.
Okay. How did you come to the conclusion? Like, you guessed? Or you...
Because at the end, he was purchased by CSK.
Okay.
So I read it somewhere like he was purchased by CSK in the post-auctions news.
That is Karan Sharma. Indeed, the right answer. Winning 3 IPL titles with 3 different teams. Some are not even able to win 1 title, but he has won 3 titles. Like, that is a very unique record, right? Like, playing for 3 different teams. And so the next question will be to Saujanya again. Like, this is a very simple question. Give me the names of women T20 challenger teams. Like, what are the names of the women T20 challenger teams which they play during IPL season? Like, give me their names. Saujanya, it is to you. It's a very pretty direct and easy question. You can unmute yourself. Like,
I'm not and recalling.
Everyone has read it, but I thought no one will remember them. So that's a very pretty direct question. Would you like to take a guess?
I'm sorry, I'm not recalling.
Okay, Shubham.
Sir, I'm really ashamed that I don't know this. I watch women cricket, but I do not.
Yeah, those matches are very interesting, right? They go down to the wire every time. Okay, then we will move to Piyush.
Do we have to name all the 3
yes,
teams?
Yes, all the 3. There are only 3.
Yeah. So I can recall the name of 2 teams, that is Trailblazers and Supernova.
However, okay, then out of 10, you will get 6. Like 6.5. Give me another name.
I cannot recall the name of that purple colored team.
Yeah.
Led by Mithali Raj.
Whom?
Trailblazers and Supernova. And I cannot recall the name of the team of Mithali Raj.
Do you want to recall or shall we move on?
Yeah, you can move.
Okay, Akhil. Any guesses?
It is IPL Velocity.
Okay, Velocity is the 3rd name. Supernovas, Velocity and Trailblazers. Like, I thought everyone watches these matches, but no, most of them do not remember. And recently also the contract scale of women cricketers was released, right? But many are complaining that the pay scale is very different for men and women. So I think the BCCI will look into it because even they provide us more entertainment. So the next question will be again directly to Saujanya because last one was answered by Akhil. Eden Gardens has hosted the most number of ODIs in India, that is 30. In the global list, it stands at 41st place because India has many stadiums. Countries with lesser stadiums end up hosting more number of matches, like Harare has hosted 151 matches, Colombo in Sri Lanka 129. Top of the list is the stadium with 240 matches. India has also scored its lowest ODI total there. Identify the stadium X. Surjan, it is to you. Like, simply give me the stadium which has hosted the most number of ODI matches, and India has scored a lowest ODI total there. There is a hint in the question. You can read the question carefully, like, which is that stadium, and you can answer it. You can take a guess. The hint is in the middle of the question, like, you can answer from there.
Is it in Colombo?
No. Shubham?
Sir, is it Melbourne Cricket Ground?
No. Then Piyush?
So is it the Sharjah Cricket Stadium?
Yes, it is Sharjah. Like, you are answering most of them. I am also wondered, like, I think you are an avid cricket follower. Well done, Piyush. How many of you have watched live cricket in stadium? Like, anybody has watched?
I have watched.
Okay, which match?
RCB versus KKR in Bangalore, Chinnaswamy.
Which season? Like,
it was 2017 season.
Oh, IPL versus KKR 2000. I think they lost very badly, right?
Yeah. It was the green
Chris Lynn. Yes, Chris Lynn had hit 100 runs, like, both together in six overs.
Chris Lynn and Sunil Nahan.
KKR and RCB have a long history. Like, every time with RCB thinks it is going to win match, someone or the other comes and hits. Any other contestants has participated? Like, watch the match in real time.
Sir, I watched the match in which MS Dhoni hit 10 sixes in Jaipur in 2005, way back.
Okay, he's against Sri Lanka?
Yes, yes.
Oh, nice, nice. It was 183, 186, something.
183.
Right? Yeah, yes. Yeah. That is also there in the MS Dhoni film. By the way, have you watched MS Dhoni film? Like, most of all of them have watched, I guess. Like, I really liked it. I don't know about others. I have also watched match in Bangalore. Yes, it's in Bangalore itself. So the next question will be to Akhil. Connect the following exhaustive list of Indian cricketers: Avesh Khan, Sarfaraz Khan, Ricky Bui, 2014-16, Ravindra Jadeja, 2006-8, Vijay Zol, 2010-14. And this list will remain exhaustive unless a BCCI removes ban. Like, until they do that, this list contains only these names. And once they do that, this list can grow. Like, what are we talking about? This is to you, Akhil. Direct. It is your direct.
Is it related to fitness test?
No. Then, Saujanya, you can guess.
Were they all part of Rajasthan Royals?
No. Shubham?
So they all played two Under-19 World Cups, I think.
Yes, that is the right one. They all played two Under-19 World Cups, but in 2016, BCCI put a ban that no player can play two Under-19 Cricket World Cups. Yes, that is the right one. Can anyone tell me where was the 2008 Under-19 World Cup held?
Singapore, Malaysia.
Yes, Malaysia. That, even I remember that, like, it was Virat Kohli's year, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, those highlights I used to watch many times. So the next question will move to Piyush. X is a former Indian cricketer who played for India as a middle order batsman and also for Boland, South Africa. X became the first cricketer in cricket history to score a century in ODI on his birthday. He has the highest career batting average for an Indian test cricketer of 54. But he played his last test when he was just 23 years old. He has also been a part of various reality shows and done a few serials and Bollywood films as an actor. He played a supporting role in the Kannada film Betta Nagari. Identify X. Like, who is this personality X? It is to Piyush Da.
Is it by any chance Vinod Kanbali?
You are saying by any chance, but that is the right answer. It is Vinod Kambli. He has the highest batting test average, but he played his last test when he was 23 years. Like, do you remember an incident involving him anywhere? Like, anyone remembers him walking out of the field? Can anyone say when was it?
The 1996 semi-final World Cup.
Yeah, it was abandoned in the midway, no, because of the riots in the stadium. In 96, after Sachin got out, so they stopped, the crowd went into riots and they stopped the match there. And I guess from then on, all the things into the stadium were banned. Like, we need to use only those things which are provided in the stadium, except our bag. So, nice one, Piyush. So, the next question will be to Akhil. It was Jason Gillespie's last test match. Australia were facing Bangladesh in 2006. Australia had bundled out Bangladesh for 197 in the first innings. Coming out to bat, the Aussies lost the wicket of Matthew Hayden just before the close of play. And as a result, Gillespie strode out to the middle in place of Ricky Ponting as a night watchman. Australia won the match by an innings and 80 runs. What feat did Gillespie achieve in this match? Akhil, it is to you. He walked out as a night watchman and Australia won that match by an innings and 80 runs. Like, what was the record he created?
Australia. He hit a double century in that match.
Like, you can refine your answer a bit.
He was the first night watchman to hit the double century.
Yes, that is the right answer. He is the first and only player who came in as a night watchman to score 200 runs. Well, that is right. I had said there are 20 questions, but as still time is remaining, I will take two extra questions. And the next direct will be to Saujanya. Okay. Plus 10 to Akhil. Connect this following exhaustive list with relation to Virat. Like, read the names in the list. Tell me, how are they connected to Virat? It's a very easy question.
And they all played. No.
Do you have a guess?
Did Alistair Cook play in IPL?
No, Shubham, you can answer.
Sir, are these all wickets of Virat Kohli?
Yes, these are the wickets of Virat Kohli. That is the right answer. Well done, Shubham. Which Virat Kohli wicket do you remember? Like, any wicket do you remember watching live?
Sir, I remember one in 2016 T20 World Cup when India was struggling and Virat Kohli came and
That was. I don't remember that. Actually, most of them say that. I remember the one he took off Kieswetter in 2012, I guess, while England were touring India. Kieswetter got bowled of him. So the final question of this quiz will be to Piyush Jha. Steve Waugh was playing the concluding match of his glorious 19-year-long international career. Walked out with a blade for the last time. Steve Waugh was on strike when the young Indian ex decided to have a go at the legend. Ex provoked Steve to try his trademark slog sweep and even predicted that he will miss it. Let's see if you can play one of those famous slog sweeps and miss one, ex said. The veteran Waugh, not so pleased with his comment, came up with a thunderous response that rendered ex speechless. He said, show a bit of respect. You were in nappies when I played my first test match. So make a calculation in the question and you can arrive at the answer very easily.
Is it Parthiv Patel?
Yes, that is Parthiv Patel. It was his famous ledge. So well done, participants. I hope each of you enjoyed. Like, I thought these were very easy questions as it was our first edition. But the toughness and the quality of questions will keep improving. So also participate in our remaining quizzes, which will come every month. Mani, can you calculate the scores?
I have calculated these scores and I think we all know these scores are pretty clear. So I'll tell the details. Yeah. So Piyush led the quiz with 101.5 points. Akhil was at 68.5 points, and Shubham was at 32.5 points, and Sojanya was at 10 points.
Okay, well done, participants. Like, congrats to Piyush, Akhil, Shubham, and Sojanya, all of you. Like, you participated in our quiz, and it is a great encouragement as the responses were good. Piyush, you can give your review about the quiz. Like, I thought the questions were very easy, right?
The questions were, some of the questions were tricky, especially the question, the question whose answer was answered by Akhil Maharaja Bhupinder Singh. I didn't know that question.
So
I got to learn a couple of facts, and that was quite interesting. So I hope that I can participate in the upcoming quizzes as well and learn some more trivia and knowledge.
We will come up with a new theme in our next quiztainment edition. So do participate. Akhil, you can say about speak about the review.
Actually, the questions for me were quite unexpected, to be honest, because many of them were related to, you know, history kind of questions. The current questions were not asked. Majority of them were from the past, like before
history,
in the 20th century, most of them.
Thank you. Keep participating. Shubham, you can give your review, like, how can we...
But I'm very thankful that I was invited to participate in this quiz, and the questions were really interesting. And, you know, I was totally blown away by the knowledge that you shared.
Because
he gave such exceptional answers, and it was a really good experience.
Thank you, Shubham. Keep participating. Sojanya, you can speak.
The historical questions were quite tough for me, but I'm embarrassed because some of them I knew, but I couldn't recall at that moment. So next time I will try hard.
Yeah, keep trying, and no point of embarrassing. It is all about guessing. Like, these type of quizzes, it is just held for trivial knowledge, right? Like, you can guess with the hints given in the question. So Mani, you can speak, like, if you want to speak anything.
Thank you everyone for participating. This was just a little effort by us in this times of pandemic. So we hope that you enjoyed our quiz. So, do tell us what kind of topics you want in this questionment series. We'll try to take that up.